Okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and good afternoon. Okay, so let's continue our discussion on properties of Laplace transform. So in this video, we will discuss on dividing a function by t. Okay, so if you have a function ft, and then you do Laplace transform, and then this will be equal to fs. Okay, if we divide our function with t, okay, and then the Laplace transform for this one is equal to integration of fs over ds. Okay, we integrate from s to infinity. Okay, so what it means is that if you can imagine, if you have a function, okay, in time domain, okay, which is this one, and then you divide it by t, okay, in a Laplace domain, so you integrate your function. Okay, so this is what it means. Okay, but we have restriction to use these properties, which is we must make sure that limit t goes to zeros for ft divided by t is exist. Okay, so let's do one example. Okay, so we have a, okay, example a. So you need to find Laplace transform for sine 2t divided by t. So in this case, if you look, you can see that, okay, sine 2t is our ft, this one, our function ft, and then we divide it by t. So we can see that our ft is equal to, okay, sine 2t. So this will give us, okay, the Laplace transform for our ft is fs, and then this will be equal to 2 over s squared plus t plus 2 squared. Okay, right. So the next one is that, okay, so we need to check the limit, because these properties has the restriction. We need to check the limit, okay, where limit t goes to zeros for ft divided by t is exist, and then after that we can use these properties. So let's check whether we have the limit, the limit exists or not for our case. Okay, so we have over here, so you have, okay, so limit t goes to zeros. Okay, so we want to check whether, yeah, our ft divided by t, and then we have the limit is exists. So what we can do, okay, to solve this, we just need to replace t with zeros. Okay, so we have sine, okay, 2 zeros, okay, and then divided by zeros. So you have sine zeros over zeros. So sine zeros is equal to zero. So you have zeros over zeros. Okay, so for this case, okay, so this is what we call undetermined cases. Okay, so you cannot determine whether the limit is exist or not. Okay, to solve this kind of situation, for example 0 and 0, or for example you can have also maybe infinity over infinity, also undetermined cases. So in order to solve this kind of problem, okay, so that we can have say that the limit is exist or not exist, so we can apply L'Hopital rule. Okay, so we can apply what we call L'Hopital rule. Okay, so this one, okay, so this one, okay, this rule, okay, so for example you have limit, okay, for example a function, over here we use a function t, and then we have ft over gt, and then outcome for this one, okay, is equal to whether is 0 0, okay, 0 over 0, or infinity over infinity, which is, this is undetermined cases. Okay, so we can use L'Hopital rule, where this will be equal to limit t goes to zeros, okay, where you need to differentiate your function, and then your FT function and GT function. Okay, and then after that we insert the t value equal to 0 into this function. Okay, alright. And then we can continue again and again. Okay, we can repeat this. Okay, so this also we can repeat this. T goes to zeros, and then function ft double prime. So you do plus your differentiation. Okay, if this one fail to find the value. Okay, for our cases. Okay, so let's do it. Okay, so over here, so you have limit. Okay, sine 2t over t, and then we want to find t goes to zeros, and then we test already this one is undetermined cases. So what we need to do is that we differentiate sine or 2t, and then differentiate our t. So this will give us, okay, so limit t goes to zeros. Okay, this gives us 2 cos 2t over t. Okay, derivative of sine 2t is equal to 2 cos t divided by t. Okay, so and then the next one is that we insert value of t equal to 0. So you have 2 cos 0 divided by 0. Okay, this one. So 2 cos 0 is equal to 1. So 1 multiplied by 2, this one equal to 2. So you have 2 over 0. Okay, meaning that you have 0. This one will be equal to 0. 2 over 0 is equal to 0. So that mean, okay, your limit exists. Okay, so the limit, okay, exists. Okay, because we have 0. Okay, so a condition where the limit is doesn't exist, so you will get value of infinity. Okay, so if you have value of infinity, so the limit does not exist. Okay, so let's continue now. We already determined that the limit is exist, so we can use the properties, okay, to find Laplace transform of our ft divided by t. Okay, so let's do it. Okay, so as in this formula, so we have our Laplace transform for our ft divided by t. This will be equal to integration of s to infinity, okay, f s over ds. Okay, this one. Okay, so our fs we already calculated. Okay, so we already calculated our fs value. Okay, so which is this one. Okay, so this will be equal to integration of s infinity s fs is 2 over s squared plus 2 squared and then ds. Okay, so this will give us this integration. Okay, so will give us two over two. Okay, tangent negative one s over two, and then the limits s to infinity. Okay, this integration, we use this properties of integration. Okay, x squared plus a squared dx. This will give us 1 over a. Okay, tangent negative 1 x over a. And then plus c. Okay, so we will use this Fourier, you can find it in Fourier in integration table. So for these cases, so you have 1 over a tangent negative 1 x over a plus c. So we can just use it using it. Okay, and then we find the limit of it. So now this will be equal to, we insert infinity. So you have this one, 2 over 2 is 1. So you have tangent negative 1. Okay, infinity divided by 2. Okay, and then negative tangent negative 1. Okay, and then s divided by 2. Okay, right. So now we have tangent negative infinity over 2, which is tangent negative infinity. So tangent negative 1 infinity negative tangent negative 1 s over 2. As we know, tangent negative 1 infinity is equal to pi over 2. So you have pi over 2 negative tangent negative 1 s over 2. So this is our Laplace transform of ft over t, where we find, we calculate this using properties of dividing a function by t. Okay, so which is this one. Okay, right. Okay, hopefully you understand it. Okay, and then see you again in the next video, and then thanks for watching, and bye.